Hi, welcome back. Now, this is video number two in the three-part couture wedding dress video series. Last week's video, we learned about Yemi, the couture designer and founder and owner of Kasiba. He shared his journey into why he wanted to be a couture designer. This video, this week, Yemi shares all about what couture is and the intricate detailed process. Hi, I'm Michelle Mays, your chief concierge for luxury wedding planning in New York and owner of Renee Michelle Events. If this is your first time visiting my channel, welcome and thank you for stopping by. Be sure you click subscribe and the notification bell so you'll know when future videos are posted. And if you're returning, thank you for coming back.
Could you bespoke? They're in the class of their own because they're made from scratch
Exactly.
and it's for unique to the client.
So we all know bespoke couture the same,
Yes.
just a different name, but the same process.
Absolutely.
Made to measure is taking something and making it to fit you.
That's correct.
And then ready to wear, we know, we go to the store, we like it, we buy it, it fits.
And then you can tailor it to, you can alter it to, you can tailor it to fit. Yeah.
Exactly.
So that's the three and the price and the reason why I wanted to clarify that is that you did mention in passing a price point. Yes, couture and bespoke have a higher price point because of the amount of work and usually the quality of fabric and embellishment used because it also involves like appliques and the decorations on the dress. Normally those are actually bespoke as well. I mean, I could show you something. If a client came to me, part of the process would be showing them things like this.
Okay,
So
yes.
this is some sort of beading that I'll show the client, and then we might say, okay, we like the top of this, and we can add a little bit there. But the whole point is that it's then created for that particular dress.
So give us some understanding of what that couturier, I'm combining the words, what the couture designer process is.
Okay, so first of all, if I dial back a bit, in my teenage years, and this was the days before everybody had a computer, before the internet. I mean, the internet existed, but before it was very ubiquitous, I'd go to the library and I'd study encyclopedia entries of designers like Dior, Balmain, Givenchy. And I was very interested in the fact that they created these fabulous looking garments, but what happened on the inside really affected what happened on the outside. They call them fixes like corsetry, boning, structure, things that people would never see. And the good thing about the encyclopedia was that they'd show you images of how the garment was constructed, and I was really fascinated with that. And that sort of struck a chord with me that if I'm ever going to make clothes, those are the sort of clothes I want to make. I want to make well-made clothes, clothes that almost defy gravity, or might look simple from the outside, but they have complicated structure inside, which in turn help to enhance the figure of my client. I'd always wanted to make beautiful clothes. As a couture designer, it involves, and this is true bespoke, true couture, you have a client in front of you. You need to know what that garment is for. So I'm going to talk from a bridal point of view. It's for a wedding. Where is the wedding going to be? What time of year? What is the location? Is it a modern setting? Like a very ultra clean minimalist hotel, or is it a rococo, almost like a castle? Because those two locations call for two entirely different dress styles depending on where the dress is going to be. And then that combined with your client in front of you, that's how you come up with a unique design. I also ask lots of questions. Some of my clients don't either have an idea of what they want as a style, and some of them have no clue. Either works with me. That's not a problem. But I ask questions, like religious or cultural elements that might come into play. Do you have to cover up? Are you, you know, are you what parts of your body do you want to show off? What parts of your body do you have issues with? A lot of, and then that helps people to understand why it costs what it costs, which is a fair question. And we as designers can't just assume everybody knows what we are doing.
I have seen your designs. Everyone viewing this video, I have seen Yemi's work, his completed work. And I have to say the love and detail that goes into each item that I have seen. That's it. No words. I mean, I adore the work. And yes, you also have items that allow a client to tailor their budget to what you have to offer. Now that you finished watching video 2 in the 3-part couture wedding gown video series, I hope it answered a lot of your questions and gave you a clear understanding of couture and why it's called couture and the whole creation process. Now, if you have any questions or comments, be sure to put them in the comment box below. Make sure you click subscribe and the notification bell, because next week's video is all about the experience involved and your input that creates the experience of creating your one-of-a-kind couture gown. We also learn about the timeline and a couple of surprises Yemi shares with us in our next video. Remember, click subscribe and the notification bell. And come back next week. And oh, if you didn't get to watch the first video in this video series, click the frame popping up now. I think it'll be over here. And make sure you go and watch the first video in the couture wedding gown, wedding dress video series. See you next week.